Hello, good morning. Welcome to the KRT Racer Focus on Zwift Community Live. I am the subject of today's broadcast of suffering. My name is Ian Anderson, and we've got 3.5 minutes to go today before we do ourselves in with half of a pretzel. So the pretzel is one of the courses that you can select on Zwift. It's probably the hardest course in the game, just in terms of intensity and challenge packed into 46 miles. Luckily for me, we're only doing half of that today. Good morning to everybody. See Roger's in the house. But just to sum up the route real quick, we basically go straight out of the gate, take a left onto the flat route, an immediate left onto the Epic KOM route, and then we're going to be climbing for about 30 minutes or so. We go all the way up to the radio tower, come back down, get back on the flat route, and then I believe we do the reverse KOM after all that, before finishing at the start-finish banner. So thanks everybody for joining. We're going to have a lot of fun. Richard says, Richard Linnell on Facebook says, have a good ride. Appreciate that. I will need it. I'm racing in the A category, so we'll see how we go. Good turnout so far, 71 riders. I'm wearing the KRT kit in the game, as you will see, and I'm also wearing the KISS Racing Team kit in real life. And appreciate everybody stopping by and saying hi, and if you have any questions, be sure to drop them in the chat. Somebody in the chat will answer if I'm suffering too hard. Otherwise, I will answer. So it's only 19 miles, but it's a tough 19 miles. Edward Wiley says, enjoy your ride. Well, I'll try. My goal is to just see how long I can stay with a group. But I know my numbers. So I just got to be careful that I make sure I finish the race. We've got an in real life race on Saturday, but I didn't really want to taper too much or do anything too different. That's what I normally do. We're going to hit it with a training stress balance of zero. I think that'll be plenty, plenty. So 40 seconds to go here. Fast start. This is a race, of course, as this is a racer focus. I'm going to start quickly, I'm sure. Power-ups are allowed, and I was Dumbo and did not go and get one before the race, but that's okay. I see Tim Cartwright in. He's probably going to double up, do a couple races today. Richard Linnell wants to know what trainer I'm using. I'm on the Wahoo Kicker, but that's not my power source. Our source is PowerTab P1 pedals, but the Kicker's a good investment. Here we go. See if people take it easy because we have to go up this mountain. The answer is relatively. There goes Tim. We'll let them deal with that. Maybe I have to deal with it too. my second. This is my second race as an A. First one was 3 laps of London Loop. So I've done almost exclusively uphill stuff. As an A so far. Zwift official says right on. That is correct. I agree with that sentiment, Zwift, as I have done every Tuesday and Thursday at 6 a.m. for the past year. This is basically my race-versary, more or less. At least a kiss-versary. When we started the Kiss Americas. Roger's giving me some strategy. Appreciate that. He's over on the Beam chat. Beam.pro/ Swift Community Live. I keep his intel to myself because it's a good nugget of knowledge. You always sort of want to have a plan. Just like real races, you sort of have a plan for the beginning and then adapt and add as it changes. Just in Zwift, it's like less likely you're going to get a puncture or a crash. But you can get a puncture if you have a wheel on trainer. That is to say, if your wheel is still on the bike. Whereas my wheel is not. So I got a front wheel on, but no back wheel. Because the Wahoo Kicker is a direct drive trainer. Okay, it's safe to reveal the strategy. I'm gonna try to stay with at least some of these boys up till we get across the bridge. Which is in a short time, coming out of the tunnel first. Important to be near the front to respond to the moves. Because not everybody in this group is going to hold the wheels. It's fine. It's something to be aware of as you race. Okay. Richard Lindell says, Zwift punctures are when all the sensors just stop. Yeah. Also, I've heard them referred to as kid flats. If you have children and they, need your attention mid-ride, that's a kid's flat. Alright, here we go. Nothing too crazy, it looks like. Just gonna hold Chan's wheel here. It's strung. They're going. Focus on Chan right now. Here we go, opening it up. Rogers is right. Rogers is saying, climb too hard. Tourists on the move. Damage control. So the resistance on my trainer is changing up right now as the gradient changes. Okay, Yoshi's letting go. Yeah, 200 pounds, 90 kilos. Six foot four though. Follow when it's dream time. But he's got it. This is Dominic. first time racing Pretzel, I believe, for Dominic. So, Paul says Shamey's at work, yep. Dominic's keeping it hard, Jim Paula. You see how he surges to get around other riders that aren't racing. Good tactic. Letting Yoshi get this. Dominic goes smooth in. There you go. Yep. Nathan Garris says, nowhere to hide on the mountain. Look at all the trees, you could hide there. Come on, Yoshi, come around. There you go. Good man. Drop out. Ah. Yeah. Wind says, let him go. Yep. I'm gonna keep it respetable. Más de tren. Okay, that's the end of my Spanish. Venga. Roger says he's gonna do an FTP test later. Might as well just do the kiss race, Rogers, and then just stop at 20 minutes. Good motivation. Thanks, Brandon, for the ride on. So notice how I have a rhythm, kind of. I feel like I have a rhythm. Yeah, I see Solvis up there somewhere. Oh yeah, he's right there. 30 seconds up. Here comes Carter. Thanks, Richard. Yeah, this is nice, honestly. Good pace, tempo. when I'm outside. When it gets up to like 10%, I just go right into the big cog, little ring. Get shoved into 60 RPM. And doing like 450 watts. Hurts. Hurts being big. Thanks, Umer. Umer Javed on Facebook says, always great to see me. Thanks for introducing yourself, Umer.
Nice!
Oh, Carter, I weigh 200 pounds. Let me get that downhill for you. There you go, Carter. Wallstrom says good work. Thanks. Macintosh, yes. 1,000 footer at once is big. For anybody. Here goes Carter. Zoom caught us. Not good. Farrington got us too. Chris Carter. I think he doesn't realize what we have to do. We have to go up the radio tower. Zund will do that all day though. He just goes. He can go on his own. Okay, Cardozo. I love the small points boost. It's the best. I think the power-ups know when you're slacking. No, Rogers. Not gonna do that. Thanks, Don. This is part of the game where the visual effect is not helpful. So it's too real. Makes you wanna stop, throw your hands up and stop. Oh, you guys see that? Game. There's no reason for me to bump into somebody at a 15% gradient. Come on, guys. Yeah, BJ. Bralia says no. Same here, Dave. Dave says he loves climbs, but he's not good at them. Thanks, Jack. Keeping that heart rate in check, really, on the cadence front. Okay, Rogers, where's the spot? We're doing it. Thank you. No. Well, that was silly. Later, Richard Bruno. Roger says to remember the sprint sections. Here we go. A little stiff at the top on the bottom of that one. One more of those, right? Thank you. This is so painful. Yeah, I'm dying though, Wardies. I can't hold 3.5. Thank you. dreadful, dreadful thing. Thanks for Rick. Yep. Yeah. Thank you, Frederick. Oh, come on. Ow. Thanks for the thanks, Jerry. All right, thanks, Wallstrom. Thanks everybody for watching. It's 7:12 local time, 6:12 central, and that can only mean one thing. In 15 minutes or so, Mrs. Coach Lindsay Guerra will be talking life and cycling on her weekly broadcast. So be sure to stay tuned for that. It's coming up shortly. Really appreciate all of the comments and encouragement in my race. Just to recap, went pretty hard at the beginning and stayed with a good group, but then basically once we got around the village, Giampaolo went away off the front, and that kept it strung out, so everybody was just trying to bridge up to him, and I didn't really have the legs to keep going with all the surges. And then once we got to the top of the radio tower, it was really blown up, so I went on the TT bike to try to catch some people on the way down. I caught a few Japanese riders, but I didn't catch the front end of the race. I guess I didn't really push as hard as I could have, but I have a real life race this Saturday, which is basically gonna be the exact same distance except flat. Flatter. So wish me luck, check me on Strava, and you will see that effort once it happens Saturday at 8 a.m. Eastern. But meanwhile, we're gonna turn things over to Mrs. Coach. She's coming on in 15 minutes to talk life and cycling. It's Lindsay Guerra, and then later today we have the Kiss Europe broadcast at 3 p.m. Eastern, 2 p.m. Central, and for all you Europeans, 8 p.m. UTC. So be sure to check out those broadcasts later today on Zwift Community Live. Really looking forward to having you joining us, and thanks for joining us this morning. All right, that's it for me. Right on.
Mm-hmm.